Hey friends, real-world data integration pipelines are complex, and they can require days of effort to put together. Typically, multiple data engineers collaborate to build these integration workflows. Gaurav Mahotra is here to show us how Git integration in Azure Data Factory simplifies this collaboration experience today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, it's Azure Friday. We're digging into the Azure Data Factory, and this one's exciting to me because you have Git integration into Azure Data Factory.
Yes, so we have Git integration for customers to do collaboration, source control, versioning, and we have made it even better with Data Factory, right? So today with Data Factory, you can essentially come and say that I want to back my entire experience with a code repo so that I can get all of these benefits. It's available for you to do that in few simple clicks. So you can come to the Data Factory Visual Tools and click Setup Code Repo. And now we have options for both DevOps Git as well as GitHub, right? And with GitHub, we support both public GitHub as well as the enterprise GitHub, which is the on-prem version of GitHub with that as well. So for this particular demo, I'm going to use Azure DevOps Git. So if I select Azure DevOps Git, we are again doing all the heavy lifting to make it super simple for customers to set up this. So we automatically pull up all the accounts that you have access to. So you can just select one of the accounts that you can do. And we automatically pull the projects. And here you can create a new repo or use an existing repo.
Okay.
And you can select the collaboration branch. So generally this collaboration branch is master, but if you want to use any other branch as collaboration, you could do that as well by clicking create new over here.
Okay.
This checkbox says that I want to import all my current stuff, which is in the Data Factory, because I could have built pipelines without enabling Git integration into the Git repo as well.
Okay.
So if I go press save, at this point, we are creating all the connections to make sure that your Git integration is enabled. And if I go to the Git repo now and refresh this, you'll be able to see that all the code representation of your Data Factory, as you saw, is here now. So
what is it? What is the format? Is it JSON or?
Yes. So if I were to click this, you can see that it's all JSON over here.
Look at that.
Yes.
You serialized effectively the entire Data Factory and all resources associated with it, in a way that can be exported and imported. But I assume other people can merge these and collaborate on them in a true Git fashion.
Yes. So now if I go over here, right, your Git repo is enabled. If I go on my authoring canvas, you can see that the Git is there and I'm working on the master branch. But you as a customer, right, like could be developing different features. Different developers in your organization could be developing different features. So they could be enabling new branches, which could be different feature branches and working off of it. And once you are done with building features, you are going to merge that back to the master.
Okay.
And from Data Factory, we only allow you to publish from the master branch. Now, one thing that I want to specify is that within Data Factory, we are not building Git inside Data Factory, right? So we are essentially for all the features, like for example, to do code reviews and merging it back to the master, we have links where we take you to the Git repo. So if you click, so what I did over here was-
You jumped over into the either GitHub or Azure DevOps. That way you understand that Azure Data Factory is using Git, but you're not reproducing any repo. You use the same flow that you're used to using.
Exactly, right? So I just clicked create pull request over here and it took you to DevOps Git. Mm-hmm. And if you had anything over here, you could merge it back to master, open code reviews and all of that, and work with Data Factory like that.
See, this is yet another example where Azure Data Factory goes to where the users are, works in the way that they want to use. You're being helpful, but you're not being overly prescriptive and saying you must do it like this.
Yes, and the other thing that this grants you is that now you could do partial saves, right? So in the, we have two modes, right? The live mode, what we call as, if you look over here, that you could essentially go in the Data Factory mode or the live mode, or you could be in the Git mode. We generally don't recommend customers to keep switching between those two because pick one, it could create complications in terms of where your like Data Factory assets are. So if you are in the Git mode over here, you can see that now there's a save button enabled. So if I have anything over here, I could essentially do partial saves, right? Now, with the Data Factory mode, this is not there, right? Because there you need to have a valid pipeline for you to publish to the Data Factory. And generally in the data integration world, your pipelines are complex, you take multiple hours to build. So if you're, and you want to do intermediate saves, right? Because you don't want to lose your work. So with Git integration, that gets enabled for you. In addition to this, your performance is faster because now we are loading from the local Git repo instead of the direct Data Factory service. Right. So you'll see a faster performance for your workflows. Also, it benefits for you to do continuous integration and deployment, right? Because a lot of time customers have different environments, right? They have a dev environment, a test environment, a prod environment, and they want to take whatever is deployed in the dev to the test and then to prod, right? So with this integration, you can enable that CI/CD, right? So here, I have a graph which essentially shows, a visual which essentially shows you how you can do that. Mm-hmm. So here, you have your different working branches. So this is essentially your Git, and you have your different working branches. You create your pull request, and you merge it to the master. And from there, you click publish in your Dev Data Factory. And the moment you click publish, we automatically generate an ADF underscore publish branch in your Git repo, and you have Azure DevOps Git release hooked up to that.
Right.
And when the first thing in that Git release is a trigger, and which gets automatically fired once a check-in happens in the ADF publish branch, and then it takes everything that's in your Dev Data Factory to a test and then to a prod. Now, because Azure DevOps release is a workflow, you could have intermediate steps to do tests before you push from one environment to another, right? So you could be using our partial commandlets to do certain tests.
You need quality gates.
Exactly, right? So this entire continuous integration and delivery pattern gets enabled once you enable Azure DevOps Git or GitHub integration with Data Factory.
Okay, so it may not be initially familiar, but it is a flow. It's just like we use Git flow for our websites and dev, test, and staging. And if you're familiar with Git, this will feel very comfortable, and it should work nicely to integrate with someone's existing Data Factory process.
Exactly, and we continue to make this more performant for the users, right? Because you can imagine you could have thousands of pipelines in which you could be pushing from one environment to another. So we have done all the hard work to split the ARM templates, because behind the scenes, we essentially use ARM templates, right? Mm-hmm. So we have done the work to split those ARM templates to make sure that you get the best-in-class performance and throughput with Data Factory.
Very cool. And this is available now, and people can make this happen with their existing Data Factories?
Yes, this is available now. We have documentation available. So if you go to our documentation, I'm actually looking at continuous integration and delivery.
Lovely.
And there's Visual Author Data Factories as well, in which you can see how you can enable the Azure DevOps Git integration or the GitHub integration with Data Factory.
Very cool. Well, this is fantastic. I am learning all about how to build data integration pipelines collaboratively using Git integration in Azure Data Factory today on Azure Friday.